Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. As a part of dimensional analysis, today I'll be discussing about the types of forces acting on a moving fluid. So whatever might be the type of force acting on a fluid which is in motion, we generally try to categorize that force to fall among these six categories. Okay, so we classify the forces acting on the fluids when the fluid is in motion into these six types. Okay, it is inertia force, viscous force, gravity force, pressure force, surface tension force and elastic force. Coming to first one, inertia force. See, inertia force is obtained by multiplying the mass of the fluid with the acceleration of the flowing fluid. Okay, mathematically your inertia force will be equal to force. You know force, right? Force is mass into acceleration. Similarly, your inertia force also will be mass into acceleration. It's the product of mass and acceleration, but the direction of inertia will be opposite in the direction of the force, or it will be opposite in the direction of motion of the fluid. So inertia is something which is resisting the motion, like friction, like viscosity. So inertia force, though in terms of magnitude it is equal to force, but it acts in the direction always opposite to the direction of the fluid or direction of the force. Okay, and this always exists in fluid flow problems. Why? Because any fluid which is in moving will be subjected to inertia which is acting exactly in opposite direction to it. Okay, and it is denoted by the symbol Fi. Next comes viscous force. So viscous force is the product of shear stress and surface area of flow. We know that viscosity means resistance offered to fluid motion by one layer of fluid with respect to the other. And I have a video on viscosity, please do watch. You have more clear explanation there. So here we have shear stress. So this shear stress into the surface area of the flow where the viscosity is tending to act, that multiplication or that product will give us the viscous force. Okay. And this viscous force comes into action when there is only viscosity coming into action, means when there is highly viscous fluid or wherever viscosity topic is discussed, we assume this viscous force to come there. Okay, it is denoted by the symbol Fv. Next comes gravity force. So gravity force always exists in case of open channels. Why? Because in open channels, water flows only under gravity. We are not giving any external agent like force or pressure to make the water to move. Not only water, any liquid in an open channel flows only under gravity with the help of a slope of the channel. Okay, and this gravity force is equal to product of mass into acceleration due to gravity of the fluid, which is m into g. It is denoted by the symbol Fg. Next comes pressure force. So pressure force is obtained by the product of pressure intensity and cross-sectional. Right, we have a formula, pressure intensity P is equal to force by cross-sectional area. Generally, pressure always acts on the cross-section. So pressure is equal to force by area. So from there, we can write force as pressure into area. Okay, and this pressure force is kind of present in pipe flows. Why? Because in pipe flow, the water is not flowing under gravity. You have to give a pressure. So, and this pressure will be varying. Say suppose there are two sections 1 and 2. The pressure at section 1 will be P1 and pressure at section 2 will be P2, like that. Okay, and it is denoted by the symbol Fp. Next comes surface tension force. So what is surface tension? Surface tension is nothing but the tensile force acting per unit length, and the surface tension comes into action when two immiscible liquids are in contact with each other or one liquid is in contact with air. And surface tension force is obtained by the product of surface tension, which is sigma into length. Okay, so it is denoted by the symbol Fs. And last one is the elastic force. Elastic force is the product of elastic stress into area. When shear force, viscous force or your shear force is shear stress into area, then elastic force will be elastic stress into area. And it is denoted by the symbol Fe. So this five types of forces, what we have, six types of forces, whatever we have discussed, what we do is these six types of forces will help us in calculation of dimensionless numbers. Okay, in dimensionless numbers, what we do is we try to put the inertia force constant and we divide the other five forces with this inertia force, and hence we will be getting five dimensionless numbers. Okay, and these dimensional numbers will be further developed into model laws that we will discuss in the next upcoming videos. So for a flowing fluid, the above mentioned force may not always be present. Means, say suppose if a fluid is flowing from section A to section B, it's not mandatory that all the six forces are acting on it. Okay, next, all the forces which are present in a fluid flow problem are not of equal magnitude. Say suppose if a fluid is flowing from section A to section B, there are two kinds of forces acting on it. Let's say that there is gravity force and there is pressure force. It's not compulsory that this gravity force, which is m into g, is equal to pressure force, which is p into a. It's not compulsory that they should be of same magnitude. They may not be, or they may be, but most of the times it will not be equal. There are always one or two forces which dominate the other forces, obviously. Now if I take the same fluid which is flowing from section A to section B, there are two forces. As I've told you, let's consider gravity force and pressure force. There will be also inertia force by default, but these two, pressure force and gravity force, are dominating the inertia force. There may be viscous force, means the liquid may be viscous, but still it is flowing under gravity, means the viscous force is dominated by these two forces. These dominating forces govern the flow of the fluid, as I've told you. So whichever is the dominant, that will make the fluid to flow. Okay, so this is about types of forces acting on the fluids, moving fluids especially. So as I've told you, the continuation of this will be dimensionless numbers, and once the dimensionless numbers are obtained, we can apply these dimensionless numbers to models, so that we can apply that model law to model and prototype, and we can try to get the relationship between them, and we can try to obtain the missing quantities of either model or prototype, such that we can know the behavior of the prototype. Hope you understood this video, and thank you.